Hello game devs, welcome to another tutorial with Moments Online. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add player lives to a platformer game in GDevelop 5. So right here is my HUD for this particular platformer. So this was created in a live video that I did. I think it's almost been a week ago. If you were on that live video, then you know what I'm talking about. Well, let's take a look at how to add player lives. So right here, you want to add a new object and then go for text. So initial text to display, set that to equal to, and then the size to 100. So I'm using this size because it fits for that of my platformer game. I'm going to go for a font which is Kenny Mini Square. This is a customized font that I use personally. Object name, I'll set this to lives. So you want to do that, you want to set the object name also and go for apply. So right here, I'm going to drag this onto the screen as my HUD. So you want to set up your HUD and then change the layer to HUD. So if you are wondering how to change your layer or set up a layer, you just want to go here, click on that, and once you click on this, you should have this display. Scroll downwards and click on add a layer. So with this, you just added a layer. You can rename it to whatever name you want to use. Okay, so I'm going to delete this since I have it already, and then close this up. With that done, the next thing is to get into new scene event. Right here, you want to add up a new empty event. I'm going to add two of them since I'll be using both of them. And then the first event, you want to go for add condition, go for common conditions for all objects, and go for collision. So you want to go for collision again, and then go for player hitbox. If you are using player hitbox, if you are not using player hitbox, you can go for player. But I'm going to go for player hitbox in this tutorial. And then the object is trap. You can use enemies also if that is going to be harmful to your player. So I'll go for OK. And then the next thing you want to add is another condition. So click on add condition. In your search, you want to type trigger and go for trigger once while true. If you do not understand why we use trigger once while true, it's just so that this occurs only once. If you do not use this, you're going to have a few problems. So you do want to use your trigger once. If you want more information about trigger once, I have a video on that, you can check it out. So I'll go for add action, and then right here I want to go for variables. So you want to do the same, go for value of a scene variable if you're going to use this in a single level. But if you're using it for multiple levels, you want to go for value of a global variable. So I'm going to go for value of a scene variable since I'm using it for a single level. And you can tell there's nothing displaying over here, so you want to click on this and then add your lives. So player lives right here as lives, and then you want to set the value to 2. So for this tutorial, it's 2. You can set it to any value you want and then click on apply. So now modification sign set to, and then the value 1. So I'm going to, let me change this. This is supposed to be subtract, not set to. So I'm going to subtract 1 for every collision with trap. Did I miss something right here? Sorry. So this is supposed to be lives. Okay, so for every collision with that of the trap, I'm going to lose a single life. So this is how it's looking like right now. So I'll go for okay. Now I want to add up the text display. So I'll go for add action, scroll downwards, and go for text objects. You want to do the same. So modify the text, and then you want to go for that of lives. Now the modification sign, you want to set that to a set to, and then you want to click on this button right here and go for variables. Once again, you can use text of a global variable if you're going to use it in multiple levels, But if you're using it for a single level, go for text of a scene variable. Now with this variable, go for lives and click on apply. Now, okay. So with this, let's check this out. So right here, when my player collides with the trap right here, I'm going to lose a life. I just lost. So right now I have a value of 0. I'll keep losing lives because it's still counting. But in an actual game, once it gets to 0, this is going to change from this scene to a new scene. So that means you're not going to be seeing the values any longer, which makes a lot of sense. But for the sake of this tutorial, there's one thing you can apply. So let me get out of this right here. And then go for add a new empty event. So this is just for tutorial. I don't know how important this will be in an actual, in a full game. That's what I'm talking about. Add condition and then variables. So right here, value of a scene variable, and then go for lives. So sign of text equal to value right here is 0. So it's going to check if the lives is set to 0. The variable lives is equal to 0. Now, if this is equal to 0, then add action. The action is going to be to hide that of the text. So right here, it's going to hide the text lives. So with this added, let's check this out. Okay, so now when I collide with the trap, I just lost a life. So now I have the text over here is no longer displaying. It's hidden because the value is now 0. So this is not going to show anything because the life is over. So you can add this up probably if you're going to, you want your game over to also display with the level of the game itself. But if you're going to be changing the scene, then this is not going to be necessary. Thank you very much for watching. If this video was helpful, don't forget to smash the like button, and I'm gonna see you in my next video. Keep creating, game devs. Arigato.